Hello everyone, this is Snigdha Mahapatra, an intern at LexClick, and the topic for today's video is formation and incorporation of a company. The whole process of formation of a company is basically divided into four stages, that is promotion, registration, flotation and commencement of business. Now first comes promotion. As the name suggests, this stage of incorporation deals with the promotion of the yet to be incorporated company. It is the stage where the promoter walks in the market of the potential investors to collect the investment towards an idea which might be his own brainchild or someone else's. The promoter induces the confidence on the idea over the investors and tries to build upon the investment so as to be able to incorporate the company. Promoter has been defined under Section 2, Subsection 69 of the Companies Act 2013. Technically, a promoter is a person so named in the prospectus of the company. The company shall also name the promoter in the annual return made under Section 96 of the Companies Act 2013. A promoter is to a company as parents is to a child. The promoter, along with convincing investors towards the idea of the company, also brings together the physical capital of the labor, raw materials, managerial ability, machinery, etc. The promoter, although is passionate towards the company's ideas, but has to SWOT analyze the idea with respect to the future prospects and feasibility with respect to the societal dynamics. Next comes registration. Section 3 states that a company may be formed by any lawful purpose by A. 7 or more persons where the company to be formed is to be a public company. B. 2 or more persons where the company to be formed is to be a private company, or C. 1 person where the company to be formed is to be a 1-person company, that is to say a private company. By subscribing to their names or his name to a memorandum and complying with the requirements of this act in respect of registration. The process of registration has been clearly stated in Section 7 of the Companies Act 2013. This provision clearly lays down the requirements for the incorporation of the company. The details of the documents namely are Memorandum of Association, which is the constitution of company, Articles of Association, that is the document filed along with MOA, List of Directors, wherein the details regarding their names, occupation and address is mentioned, Written Consent of the Directors, the consent of the directors is to be submitted to the registrar of the companies, and verification document, wherein such document is to be digitally signed by any recognized chartered accountant, company secretary or advocate. The process then involves filing up the form online with the registrar of Central Registration Center. The form is called Simplified Proforma for Incorporation. The proforma gives a viable option to incorporate a company online, which starts by filling up the details regarding the information of the promoter of the company. Secondly, the electronic proforma in the form number INC 33 and INC 34 provides the option of filling up the EMOA, that is Memorandum of Association, and EAOA, that is Article of Association, respectively. All the documents declared to be necessary under Section 7 of the Companies Act are supposed to be attached along with the digital signature of all the directors. The single window clearance regarding the incorporation of company was an action taken by the central government of India to increase the feasibility and scope of the incorporation even further. Thirdly comes the certificate of incorporation. After scrutinizing the documents filed and on being satisfied that they are in order, that the requisite fee has been paid and that all other legal requirements have been duly complied with, the registrar will enter the name of the company in the register of companies and shall certify under his hand that the company is incorporated, and in the case of a limited company, that the company is limited. He would then issue a certificate in the prescribed form number INC 111 under his signature, certifying that the company is incorporated. With reference to 31/2017, the certificate of incorporation shall also contain PAN of the company where it has been issued by the Income Tax Department. Certificate of incorporation constitutes the company's birth, and the company becomes a body corporate with perpetual succession and a common seal. the company comes into existence on the date given in the certificate of incorporation. Last but not the least is the commencement of business. As soon as a private company gets the certification of incorporation, it can start its business. Once the certificate of incorporation is received by the company, a public company issues a prospectus for inviting the public to subscribe to its share capital. It fixes the minimum subscription in the prospectus. Then it is required to sell the minimum number of shares mentioned in the prospectus. Section 10A inserted by the Companies Amendment Act 2019 requires a declaration to be made by the director of a company incorporated post the commencement of Ordinance 2019 within 180 days of its incorporation, to the effect that all the subscribers to the memorandum have paid agreed value of the shares, and the registered office of the company so incorporated has been verified by the filling of requisite returns. Thank you so much for watching the video. Subscribe to the channel and keep watching. Thank you.